In the title of this video, I promised that you will understand how to use a gate and everything you need to know about it. So here's the simplest way I can explain it. First of all, a gate is just a big door. In fact, this behind me is a gate. But why am I showing you this? Well, the gate on your mixing console works exactly the same way like a physical gate. Example number one. This gate weighs 50 kilograms. I can push 60 kilograms. So if I walk into it, I am strong enough to just push it and go to the other side, right? Scenario number two, this gate still weighs 50 kilograms, but I can only push 40 kilograms. If I go up to it and I start pushing and pushing and pushing, I cannot move the gate. I cannot pass through it. The gate will not open. So the threshold of the gate is like how heavy it is, how difficult it is to open. The higher the threshold, the heavier the gate, the more difficult it is to open, the lower the threshold, the lighter the gate, the easier it is to open. These are my drum channels. I'm gonna mute all of them except for the kick drum. So I'm gonna select the kick drum, turn on the gate, and if I click view, I can see the gate on the screen right here. I'm gonna start by raising the threshold, and now it's cutting off everything that is not the kick. So this little dot right here, this is how strong the signal is. If it's higher than threshold, the gate opens. If it's lower than threshold, the gate stays closed. Okay, the threshold is at that point where these lines are intersecting. Now, after you open the gate, it doesn't just stay open like that. It has springs on the joints, so it will automatically close on its own. So the attack and release times on the gate are exactly like the springs. If the springs are very tight and the signal tries to open the gate, it will take some time before it actually starts moving. And we call that a slow attack, because when the signal hits, the gate doesn't automatically respond and open. It takes a while to open. Now, if the springs are very loose and the signal tries to open the gate, it will open immediately because there is no resistance. So that is a fast attack time.
The attack time is how fast or slow the gate opens. So the lower the number, the faster the attack, the quicker the gate will open. If you have something like drums, you would want a fast attack because a slower attack will make it soft. A faster attack will make it very punchy, or will keep it punchy. But don't go all the way down to zero, because at zero it creates an artifact that sounds very unpleasant. So put it the minimum at 2 or 1, it's still fine, but don't put it at zero because it gives an unpleasant sound.
Now when it comes to the release time, it's similar, but works in the opposite way. So if the springs are very tight, as soon as the signal stops pushing on the gate, it will close immediately. If the springs are very loose, as soon as the signal stops pushing on the gate, it will take some time to close. And while it is closing, some other signals that are weaker can also pass through it.
The release is how long does it take to close back. If you have a very quick release, it chops the sound immediately. Maybe that's what you want, but if you want to keep the tail of the sound, you're going to have to put a longer release. Now, too much release time will keep extra unwanted sounds that you don't want. So don't make it too long, just enough to keep the tail of the sound, but not too short to where you're cutting the sound.
Now the hold is very interesting. It's like the security guy that stands next to the door. So you have a signal that opened the gate. That gate took some time to open, but that signal has some friends. So the signal passes through, is not pushing the gate anymore. That hold is like the security guy who's like, come on, sir, I'll hold the door for you while the others pass. And after a while, I'm gonna let it go. After letting it go, it takes some time to close. And that's the release time. Okay, so attack, how long does it take to open? Hold,
is like that security guy holding it open, because remember, it has springs, it closes on its own, so you need someone to hold it, to keep it open, and after that holding guy lets go, it will close and it will take some time to close, and that's the release time.
Threshold, attack, and release, these three are arguably the most important settings on a gate, but there's more. You have the hold, which is important, but not as crucial as the attack and release, and you also have a knob called range. So what does that do exactly? But before we talk about that, hit the like button if you're finding this video helpful so far. Thank you.
By default, when this signal gets below the threshold, the gate will push it straight down all the way till you can't hear it anymore. But if you lower the range, you're telling the gate, I don't want to mute it entirely, I just want to push it down initially by this amount and then leave it alone. So if you have low number on the range, you're just attenuating the signal a little bit, just from here till here, from this level till this level, and then leaving it alone. And that gives you a more natural sound, so it doesn't cut off entirely.
Now, a sidechain is like a gatekeeper who is standing in front of the gate and doesn't let anyone go through it, no matter how strong they are, unless his boss calls him and tells him to open the gate. So the boss is the triggering channel that you choose in the sidechain, and the sidechain itself is like the gatekeeper. If that channel tells the gatekeeper to open the gate, it will open the gate and let the signal pass through. And if it doesn't tell it, if there's no signal on that other channel, the gatekeeper will not open the gate to any signal, no matter how strong it is.
Here's how sidechaining works. I have a guitar channel right here. I'm gonna select it and turn on the gate and click view to see it. Now right here, you have a key source section. This is to tell the gate what to listen to in order to know if it should work or not. So by default, it's listening to self, which means the channel itself. But I don't want that. I want the gate to be controlled by another channel. So I'm gonna hit the down arrow button to go to the second page to be able to control that section. I'm gonna select channel number one, and channel number one has the kick drum. So if the kick drum hits, I want the gate to react. I'm gonna raise the threshold. And now the gate is only listening to the kick drum to know whether it should open or close. Okay, so if the kick drum doesn't hit, the gate stays closed even though it is on the guitar channel. Cool? So whenever the kick drum hits, the gate opens, we hear the guitar. If it doesn't hit, the gate stays closed, we don't hear the guitar. Now for a quick sidechain, this is enough. But if you only want a certain part of that other channel to trigger the gate or a certain frequency range, so maybe you want to open the gate only when there's too much high frequencies in the other channel or too much low frequencies, you can do that. On the second page of the gate, you have a key filter, and that key filter is telling the gate to only listen to a part of the selected channel. So if I turn it on and hit the key solo, now I'm listening to what the filter is listening to from that channel. Okay, you can change the frequency. You can select to only listen to the higher frequencies or the lower frequencies. And you have different types of filters. The first one is a low cut, so it's listening to the higher frequencies from this frequency and up. 6 means 6 dBs per octave. 12 is 12 dBs per octave. It's steeper. 12 is steeper than 6. You also have a high cut filter, which takes in all the lower frequencies from that selected frequency. And you have also 12 dBs per octave and 6 dBs per octave. And you have a band pass filter. The band pass filter has a Q, is either narrow or wide. Okay, and you can choose how narrow or wide with this number. The higher the number, the narrower it is, the less frequencies it's going to take in. The lower the number, the wider it is, the more frequencies it's going to take in. Okay, so I'm going to select low cut. And right now, if I uncheck key solo, this gate will only listen to the frequencies above that frequency that is coming from this channel. So if I take it all the way up, this is a kick drum. The kick drum doesn't have these higher frequencies. So the gate is not opening because there's not enough of these high frequencies that the filter is listening to. If I uncheck key filter, it will work normally. But if this is turned on, then I have to select a frequency that actually exceeds the threshold. And only when that frequency comes in, then the gate will open.
We're not done yet, because we still have a knob that changes the modes of the gate. So if you turn it, you'll see expander and duck. Let's talk about that.
If I turn the knob, you'll see expander. But what is an expander? An expander is the exact opposite of a compressor. On a compressor, if the signal gets above the threshold, the compressor will push it down so that the loudest parts are closer to the quietest parts. It squishes it together. An expander expands the signal, so the quieter parts get even more quiet so that they are further away from the louder parts. Okay? It expands the signal. Now, a gate is an extreme version of an expander. It's just an expander with a very high ratio, just like a limiter is a compressor with a very high ratio. Okay? Now, if you turn this knob all the way to this side, you'll see something that's called duck. What the duck does is that if the signal exceeds that threshold, it will push it down straight away. And it's usually used with a sidechain. So I have a sidechain right here that is listening to the kick channel. So if I raise the threshold, the kick channel does not exceed that threshold, so nothing happens to the guitar. But if I lower the threshold, the kick signal exceeds that threshold and is pushing down the guitar signal when the kick hits.
Now, I personally never use the duck mode because I find it too abrupt. I would rather do the ducking with a compressor instead. So click on this video right here to learn how to do that and learn everything about compression and all the parameters and how to do parallel compression and limiting. Click right here and I'll see you in the next video.